Alrighty guys, what's going on? Welcome back to the Illinois Tech Dynasty. Today we're going to go through the first recruiting update of the season. Not a super long video, is also going to be missing some things because I need to be on a plane to San Diego in a couple of hours. So I need to get this video done and finish packing. But let's go through the team overview and start with the defense. We have two red areas on the defense right now, defensive tackle and free safety. We're losing two seniors this year, DT and one free safety and Deion Reeves. So as you guys will see in a couple of minutes, we are recruiting pretty heavily in that area. But looking ahead, looking at the juniors, right? We've got three outside linebackers at junior, but we have three sophomores, so we're not really heavily recruiting there. We're going to have two seniors at defensive end next season, although our freshman and sophomore are the starters with Quentin McKenzie and Thomas Corbin, but we still need backups in case some injury happens, although we've been pretty lucky with injuries so far. Middle linebacker is pretty good. We've got corner that's pretty, you know, I mean, four freshmen. We're probably going to end up moving some guys around. So free safety might not be a big need for this next year because I have a couple of guys that are redshirted this year at corner that could slide over. But then again, if we can find guys in the recruiting boards for this year, we'll probably do that. Strong safety, not too shabby. Although I do think that we need to find an upgrade over Jack Cobbs, who is the freshman right now, and Cam Minks is no good as well. We need a coverage strong safety. And right now, Gabe Hunter is a junior. He'll be gone after, or he'll be a senior next year, but then be gone the year after that. So it's time to start looking for another strong safety. And then our punter, Patrick Lewis, he'll be here next year, but the year after that, he'll be gone. So we need to start looking at a punter maybe this year, maybe redshirt him. Then moving on to the offense, we've got one red area. That is obviously kicker with Jesus Gonzalez being a senior. So we're going to have to look for a kicker definitely this year. Maybe, you know, find a puncher that we can move over that is a strong leg. Quarterback, we have a pretty interesting situation going on at QB this year. We have Sean Kelly starting. He'll be a senior next year. The other junior, Nate Taylor, is being redshirted. So we'll have Sean Kelly play next season as well. When Kelly leaves, we'll probably slide Nate Taylor into the starting lineup. But then after that, Nate Taylor's a senior, and we're only going to have Nate Valeri on the roster, who is right now, I think, a 63 or 64 overall, and he's very slow. He's a typical pocket passing QB. So we'll definitely have to find a QB at some point, but right now it's not a huge need. Running back, we're okay, although we're losing two seniors this year. We'll be stuck with three juniors next season. Doing a pretty good job of rotating in the wide receivers. We could use some more tight ends, but the offensive line, we have got to start building that line. We have one senior guard, two junior tackles, three junior guards, and two junior centers, and not a lot of guys behind them to take over when things are done with their careers. So we wasted about 3 minutes. Let's go into the recruiting board finally. First up, the number one player on my board. This is a must get for us this year. Athlete Marcus O'Brien, number 44, from Lincolnton, North Carolina. This kid can literally do everything except play offensive line and defensive line and maybe linebacker, but the speed's there, the jumping's there. This kid can tackle about as well as the other corners we have on the roster right now. He's got great pursuit, great play recognition. The coverage ability is there, and he can also throw the ball and catch the ball. I mean, this kid can literally do it all, and the crazy thing is that he's so good. And the teams on his board, teams that you think would be going after a guy like this, Ohio State, Oklahoma, they're not even recruiting him. So this could be a major steal for our program. And he's almost ready to schedule a visit. He's almost there, just a little shy. Moving on to the number two player on our board, that is Deron Kelsey, kicker from Bensenville, Illinois, right now number two behind NIU. He is the number 32 kicker. He's a power kicker with 81 power and 72 accuracy, so a very good kicker, exactly what we're looking for. We're putting 805 points into this guy, and we're still losing in the points battle to NIU. Lane Kiffin is about to piss me off, but he is scheduled to visit NIU week 7, and he's ready to visit Illinois Tech as well. But the big question is, when do we bring him in? He's going to get a 100-point bonus for a week 7 visit with NIU. We could bring him in week 5 during our bye and get a 500-point bonus, or a week 8 visit and get 600 points. But our schedule this year, I knew this was going to be a problem. Our schedule is really going to mess up our recruiting. We do not have another home game until week 8. We have a bye week after the game being in Cincinnati. Then we're on the road. Then we're on the road again. and then we're back at home against Miami, Ohio, then back on the road again. So our schedule's not really doing us a lot of favors when it comes to recruiting. But moving on to number three on our board, this is Jarrett Johnson from Selma, Alabama, the run stopper, number 12 middle linebacker. He is a guy that I really consider to be more of an outside linebacker, although he could blitz up the middle, but we need edge rushers. And I'm looking for this guy to come in and do his thing. Maybe he'll play middle linebacker next year, but we're so backed up at linebacker that honestly, I don't really know if we need this guy, but I like him. So we're going to try to get him. And we're looking at the teams that he's interested in right now. We are number one. Everyone else is well far behind. Wisconsin, very behind. South Alabama, very behind. And Michigan, Penn State, and Texas not even looking at the kid. So that's good for us. And then he's almost ready for a visit as well. So hopefully, this annoys me. This is literally right on the line at 50%. And this is keeping us from scheduling a visit for him. But moving on to number four on our board, this is Larson Decker from Anaheim, California. Obviously, we just talked about free safety, and Larson Decker is, to me, one of the best in the class. He's got really good speed. He's a decent tackler. He's got good pursuit. He's got good play recognition. He plays pretty good coverage. 70 man, 79 zone. Block shedding could be a little higher, but then again, not a huge deal. We are slowly starting to fall behind Minnesota. I didn't put 500 points into him last week, but I'm trying it this week to see if that'll get us kind of back into this race, because right now we're 530 points behind and he's not ready for a visit quite yet. But just in case we can't get Larson Decker, there is JUCO free safety Noah Harrell from Palm Bay, Florida. 6'3", 199, number 75 when it comes to free safeties. Another gem. Very similar skill set when it comes to speed compared to Larson Decker, but the coverage ability not as great, but the tackling and the hit power makes me think that this guy could potentially be a starting strong safety rather than a free safety, because we really need to start sitting our strong safety in the box to help against the run, but not being very heavily recruited, so another guy we could potentially bring in. Moving on to number six, this is Marcus Webster, the corner from Long Beach, California, number 30, and again, guys flying under the radar with such talent. A gem, 71 overall plus 5. He's got the speed. He's got great coverage ability. 83 man, 81 zone. Block shed's an issue. Tackling's okay. Like I said, that's pretty average for the coverage corners. But this kid coming in as a freshman, just adding so much talent to our young secondary. And he's not being recruited by Cal, Boston College, Penn State, or Minnesota. So good thing for us. Another corner now, number 7 on our board. This is Cole Hardy, just added onto the board last week from Weddington, North Carolina. Number 75 corner, 6'1", 187. Comparing him to Marcus Webster, he's a little slower and his tackling is not as great, but he has the same kind of man coverage, zone coverage ability. Pretty good block shed at 57. That's not horrible. But he's a guy that I really like, so we'll probably try to bring him in at some point. We're also jumping into first place with him after 1 week of being on our board, as Ohio State's probably not recruiting him very heavily. But that'll take us to number 8 on our recruiting board, and that's the number 5 defensive end in the country. Reggie Archer from Wilmette, Illinois, trying to build that Illinois pipeline, 6'1", 248. Great skill set. He's got speed. He's got the power move. He's got the finesse move. The block shedding is there. The tackling there, the hit power, the pursuit. This kid is a stud. But the only problem is, where am I going to put him? Because Thomas Corbin's great. Quinn McKenzie is great. And honestly, right now, we're not doing that well when it comes to the recruiting battle with him, although he is ready for a visit. So he's visiting Wisconsin, the leader team, in week 13, visiting Ball State in week 9. So my big concern here is we could potentially fall off the board before week 8, but then again, I don't want to give that point lead to Wisconsin for their week 13 visit. So we're going to try to play with the numbers later when I do another update. Dan Irby at center from Alois, Wisconsin, 71 pass block, 80 run block, 75 impact. Very good center. We're going to need one because we're losing both of our juniors next season who will be seniors. And we are currently leading for him over Michigan. So this is very good for us. Moving on to offensive tackle Maurice Riley, one-star JUCO player from Hattiesburg, Mississippi. And honestly, his ratings are much better than a one-star, although his impact block is pretty bad. He's got 77 pass and 81 run block plus 80 strength. I mean, that's pretty good. And he's only a one star, so he's going to be flying under the radar. And right now we're putting 210 into him. And it looks like other teams outside of Illinois aren't really looking at this guy. So we're jumping in at the right time, bringing in a pretty solid tackle, maybe as a placeholder. But then moving on to my favorite offensive lineman on our board, Shedrick Richardson from Inglewood, California. The California pipeline will be real this year. 6'7", 315, the number 26 guard. 81 strength, 81 pass block, 81 run, 72 impact. And this kid can run for an offensive lineman. He's going to be pulling. He's going to be doing a lot of blocking. I cannot wait to see this guy. And no team, or I'm not going to say no team, but Oregon's recruiting him very lightly. And the other teams are recruiting him at all. So moving on to number 12 on the board. This is Justin Millens from Glenview, Illinois. Number 41 tight end, 6'2", 247. A blocking tight end that has the skill set of a fullback, in my opinion. He's got pretty decent speed. He's got great elusiveness. He can break tackles. He can't really catch the football, but he's a great blocker. 72 pass, 73 run, and 81 impact. And right now, Iowa recruiting him very lightly. Illinois recruiting him very lightly. Northwestern recruiting very lightly. And then the other three teams aren't even looking at him. So this is really nothing but good news for us. Moving on to another big lineman. Charlie Daniels, 6'5", 304 from Wichita, Kansas. Number 31 tackle. And again, another guy with a pretty strong skill set that's not being looked at. 80 strength, 75 pass, 75 run, 86 impact. But then again, there's probably better offensive linemen that we can't even go after right now. But this is a good guy for us. And the other teams on his board, Arizona State, Colorado, and Tulane, not even looking at him. Moving on to guard David James, another guy I like a lot. And Georgia State is kind of making this a little bit of a race to the finish line. Number 78 guard, a gem, 79 strength, 77 pass block, 78 run, 81 impact. Pretty strong player there. And we're starting to pull away from Georgia State, as they're falling behind 10 points now. We're putting 380 points plus a 285 bonus. That's a lot of points. And we're doing the same thing with guard Blake Jackson. Jackson, 6'3", 324, another big boy from Overlook, Page Manor, Ohio. There's a lot of guys on our team from that city. I don't know what's going on, but 63 speed. So he's not crazy quick for a guard, but 81 strength is great. 75 pass blocks, 76 run. Impact wasn't too bad either. And we are leading over Toledo, but Toledo is gaining despite where, how many points are we putting into this guy? I mean, that's over 600 points, and they're still catching up. Moving on back to defensive line, Marcus McNamara from Temple Terrace, Florida. 6'3", 244, another defensive end that I consider to be more of a backup, but a pretty solid backup at that. Strength isn't that great. Power move is pretty good. Finesse move is not great at all. Block shed's okay. Maybe this guy can play outside linebacker and just be a straight-up pass rusher, because I don't really think he's going to fit in at defensive end. Same thing with Gerald Jones. 6'1", 246. The number 116 defensive end from Knoxville, Tennessee. And this is another guy that's not really being recruited that heavily by the teams on his board. These two guys, I don't know what they're thinking, but they're not, you know, Power 5 conference players. But we're going to show them some love. We're going to bring them in and try to make them all-star players. USC not looking at them. Michigan State, Notre Dame, Iowa not looking at them. Trying to strengthen the defensive line at defensive tackle might take the help of Patrick Hawkins from Vidor, Texas. 6'5", 262, the perfect nose tackle for what we're trying to do here at Illinois Tech and be a 3-14, but we're having to rely a lot on 4-2-5 and 4-3 because we just don't have the talent to run a 3-4. But he comes in 73 overall, 84 power moves, 75 finesse, 75 block shed. If this dude was a freshman, oh my goodness. He will be amazing, but he's coming in as a junior. And again, he's not being recruited by the teams that he's looking at. UCLA, not looking at him. Arizona State, not looking at him. And another guy that's literally right on the line for a visit. And we're only putting 100 points into the guy plus the 275 bonus. So we're doing pretty good there. Outside linebacker, Dan Sellers from Valley Station, Kentucky. Outside linebacker, not really a position of need, but we do want to find some guys that have good coverage ability. And Dan Sellers comes in with a pretty good combination of speed, tackling ability, also pass rushing. and coverage. 71 man, 70 zone, the best outside linebacker that we would probably have on the roster next year when it comes to pass coverage. And he's not being looked at by any team in his top six. So we're going to be most likely coming away with Dan Sellers. Back to defensive line, Brian Harris out of Yorba Linda, California. Number 51 defensive tackle, 6'3", 294, not as big as Hawkins. The skill set not as great, but the ceiling is very high. Starts out with a 73 power move, 70 finesse move, 73 block shed, 77 strength. Good tackling, good hit power, good pursuit. And he's not being recruited at all by USC, and Army is recruiting, but we're right behind them. So if I shift the points a little more towards Brian Harris, we could potentially bring him in by midseason. I have about 1,000 points to spend because I just took some guys off our board. But moving on to Kevin Todd out of Neenah, Wisconsin, the number 84 defensive tackle. 6'3", 292. The size not great here, but a good backup. 65 overall. Again, not the greatest skill set with that finesse move, 53, but the power move's okay, block shedding's okay. Tackling not great, hit power not great, pursuit not great. So Brian Harris definitely a better prospect, but Kevin Todd has a pretty high ceiling if we bring him in redshirt and let him develop, and then I'll leave him in as a couple of years as a backup. Moving on to receiver, the first receiver on the board, another guy from Ohio. This is Oliver Carson, 5'11", 184, and a guy that I'm really looking to be more of a special teamer than anything else. 63 catching, 54 spec catch, 61 catch in traffic. Not great, but 91 speed, 85 agility, 86 acceleration. He ran like a 4, I think it was a 4.43 40. And none of the other teams on his board are looking to bring him in. Pitt, no. Michigan, no. Penn State, no. Auburn, no. So we have a pretty much straightaway race with Oliver Carson. We could probably take points away from him at this point. But Austin Allen, another guy that I'm not really looking to play the position that he's listed under. This would be a guy that I'm looking to play more of a special teams role, maybe gunner or maybe return man. But then again, if he has a good catch rating with those attributes, he could maybe play receiver, maybe just be a gadget player for us if we somehow can't bring in Oliver Carson. But we are coming behind on Northwestern and on Missouri for him. Moving on to the other athlete on our board, Dominique Gibbs from Ocoee, Florida. I think I pronounced that right, but 6'5", 297. Athletes are kind of hard to figure out because sometimes they have really, really good attributes in a lot of different places. Dominique Gibbs is not one of those guys. This guy was meant to play on the defensive line. Block shedding is pretty good. The finesse move is not great. Power move is okay. The strength is pretty good. And the speed's okay. So he will definitely, if we can bring him in, be playing defensive tackle or defensive end, most likely DT with that height and that size. But this is looking to be a race to the finish line as we just added him on the board last week. And then moving on to punter Corey Perkins, the only punter on the board, just preparing for the future. 6'3", 206 from Hannibal, Missouri, a gym punter. Again, punter not a really big need for us, but this, he's okay. He could be, you know, recruited this year, redshirted next year, and then ready to start in two seasons. But moving on to middle linebacker Asher Yodea, one of the two subscribers left on our board, the number one middle linebacker, and we are steadily falling behind despite offering the first scholarship in week one and beating Purdue last week. And somehow Purdue still leads. I don't understand this, but it's cool because we're going to try to bring him in. But the big question is, when do we bring him in? We five already occupied by Purdue. They're getting 700 bonus points, which could lock him up. So this is not good. Week 8 might be a little too late because our schedule really hates us. But then we move on to the other subscriber, Christian Chambers, from Lake City, South Carolina, 6'6", 225. Could be the tallest player on the team on offense because I think we have a 6'7 offensive lineman. But I'm not going to lie, I took Christian Chambers off the board earlier in the year because we fell back like 500 points through the first 2 weeks. I came back, looked at him in week 3. Somehow we were back in the race, and then now we have the lead. So unfortunately, that guys will have to do it for this video. I am running terribly behind right now. This video took way too long to get out. There's a couple other things I wanted to show, like where the other 9 guys that were subscribers are currently ending up, but I just don't have time to do it. So what I'll probably end up doing, maybe week 5, I'll probably do another recruiting update, or maybe later in the year, or maybe just throughout the year. Maybe I'll just wait till the end of the year to show where guys are going. But thank you all for tuning in. That is going to do it for this video. I have got to finish packing for real because I am running so far behind. But the week four matchup against the Bearcats will be up next week. I'll be out of town for the weekend and Monday. So we're probably going to get that video maybe Tuesday or Wednesday. But Twitter would be the best place to find out when that video is being uploaded. Thank you all for tuning in. Hope you enjoyed. I will see you guys next time. Have a nice weekend.